students, how are you all? Are you all fine? Okay, I hope you all are good and fine. Also staying safe at your home during these corona days, okay? Yes. And are you ready to learn English? Yes? Okay. So, did I told you something in the last class? Yes? What was that? Yes, I told you to read the chapter 3 times. Yes, and did you do that? Yes? Can I check? Are you ready to face my questions? Okay, then I'm going to ask some of the questions to you. Okay, what's the title of our chapter? Uncle Ken. Who wrote it? Or who's the author? Ruskin Bond. Who's the boy in this chapter? Yes, Ruskin Bond. Who's Uncle Ken? Uncle Ken is a 40 years old man who doesn't like to work. Okay, what was the first question asked by the Maharaja in the interview? Do you know tennis? Yes. And what was the reply? Yes. How he told that? By remembering that he used to play tennis during his school days. And what was the second question? Yes. Were you at Cambridge? And what was the reply? Yes. The reply was, no, I was at Oxford. Yes, so I hope you all read the chapter. Okay, so can we move on to the next session? Yes? Okay, then all of you be ready with your textbooks. Okay, are you ready? Yes, then take your book and page number 12. Okay, so can we start? Yes. The Maharaja's children were smaller than me. Uncle Ken would leave me with saying, just see that they do their sums properly, Ruskin. And he would stroll off to the tennis courts, hands in his pockets, whistling tunelessly. So, this Maharaja's children were smaller than Ruskin Bond. So, what our Uncle Ken will do? Will tell this Ruskin Bond that, just see that they do their sums properly, Ruskin. And what he'll do? He'll go to the court and he'll play tennis from there. Okay, with whom? With Maharaja. Anyway, whenever he is going somewhere, how he'll go? He just put his hands in his pockets and whistling tunelessly and simply walk from there. Okay, then. Even his pupils had different answers to the same sum. He would give both of them an encouraging pat. Say, excellent, excellent. I'm glad to see both of you trying so hard. One of you is right and one of you is wrong. But as I don't want to discourage either of you, I won't say who's right and who's wrong. But afterwards, on the way home, he'd ask me, which was the right answer, Ruskin? So, he will be giving some problems to the students. That means the children. Okay, the boy and the girl. And they'll is sometimes in some of the sums, they'll be getting different answers. Okay, at that time, what he'll do? He'll say that one of you is right and one of you is wrong. But anyway, I won't say who is right and who is wrong. And what he will do, he'll encourage them by giving a pat on their shoulder. Okay. Yes. Then, after returning to home, what he will do? He'll ask Ruskin, which was the right answer? And he'll say the right answer to him. Okay. Uncle Ken always maintained that he would never have lost his job if he had not beaten the Maharaja at tennis. Okay. So, whenever he won the match, what will happen? He'll lose his job. He know that. So, every time he'll lose and the Maharaja will win. Okay. Then. Not that Uncle Ken had any intention of winning, but by playing occasional games with the Maharaja's secretaries and guests, his channels had improved, and so try as hard as he might to lose, he couldn't help winning a match against his employer. Anyway, he didn't have any intention to win in the match, but by playing with his secretaries, that means the Maharaja secretaries, anyway, he improved a little bit. Okay, but he don't have any intention to win with the Maharaja. Anyway, he want to sustain his job. So for that, what he want to do? Always he want to lose in the game. Okay, the Maharaja was furious. "Mr. Clerk," he said sternly, "I don't think you realize the importance of losing. We can't all win, you know. Where would the world be without losers?" "I'm terribly sorry," said Uncle Ken. "It was just a fluke, Your Highness. And what happened one day while playing the tennis? Who won?" "Yes, Uncle Ken won." So the Maharaja got angry anyway, but what he told? "Hey, Uncle Ken or Kenneth Clerk, do you know the importance of losing? There will be no one without losing." Okay, so he told, "Forgive me, Maharaja, I don't know how it happens. It's just a fluke." What? It's just a fluke. What do you mean by fluke? Fluke. Are you familiar with the word fluke? Yes, it is an unexpected occurrence, a surprising piece of luck. Yes. The Maharaja accepted Uncle Ken's apologies. But a week later, it happened again. Kenneth Clerk won, and the Maharaja stormed off the court without saying a word. The following day, he turned up at lesson time. As usual, Uncle Ken and the children were engaged in a game of nouns and crosses. So, at that time, Maharaja accepted the apology of Uncle Ken. But a week later, again it happened. What? Yes, Uncle Ken won. And without saying a word, the Maharaja stormed off the court and he went from there. So, as usual, Uncle Ken went to the children and started teaching them. And also, they were playing a sort of game. What is the name of the game? That is nouns and crosses. Nouns and crosses. Okay, nouns and crosses. That means a childish game in which two players try to complete a row of either three nouns or three crosses drawn alternately in the space of a grid of 9 squares. Okay, this is a mathematical game. So they were playing this game. "We won't be requiring your service from tomorrow, Mr. Clerk. I've been asked my secretary to give you a month's salary in lieu of notice." So Maharaja came to Uncle Ken and told that, "We won't be requiring your service from tomorrow. And I told my secretary to give you the salary in advance." Okay, 1 month salary in advance. Do you know what is the meaning of in lieu of notice? Here is the term salary in lieu of notice. That means an amount of salary paid to an employee who is dismissed from service without advance warning being given to him. Okay, so in advance, while he was dismissed from his job, he got 1 month's salary. Okay, yes. Then Uncle Ken came home with his hands in his pockets, whistling cheerfully. "You are early," said Granny. "They don't need me anymore," said Uncle Ken. So, without any problem, he just went to his home. Very cheerfully he went there. Okay. And when he reached home, his mother asked, "Today you are too early, Ken." And he told that, "They don't need my service anymore." That means he lost his job. "Oh, well, never mind. Come in and have your tea. Granny must have known the job wouldn't last very long, and she wasn't one to nag, as she said later. At least he tried, and it lasted longer than most of his jobs. That is 2 months. Okay, anyway, Granny didn't told anything. Why? Because she understood that anyway he tried for this job and he worked for 2 months. It itself is too much for her. Okay, anyway, if he went to go for any other work, he didn't stay there for 2 months and all. So she told that, and it lasted longer than most of his jobs, that is 2 months. Okay, do you understood the story? Yes. So this is an extract from Life with Uncle Ken by Ruskin Bond. Okay, so I hope you understood the whole story, isn't it? Yes. Okay, then I want to ask you some questions to check whether you understood this. Okay, so what was the first question asked by the Maharaja in the interview? Yes, do you know? Tennis. And what was in the second question? Were you at Cambridge? Okay. And for the question, were you at Cambridge? What was his reply? No, I was at Oxford. Okay. So, this Uncle Ken had been to the Oxford University? No. He was there at Oxford with his Uncle Jim to help him in his business. Yes. Then, is this Uncle Ken is too intelligent in arithmetic or subtraction? No. And how he used to manage it? Yes, he accompany Ruskin Bond with him and he'll help him to find out the answers. Okay. Then, how this Uncle Ken improved his tennis? Yes, by playing with Maharaja's secretaries. Anyway, he improved tennis. And what happened when the second time he won the tennis? Yes, Maharaja stormed off the court without saying a word. And after some time, he came to Uncle Ken and told that, tomorrow onwards, we don't want your service. And I told my secretary to give you 1 month's salary in advance. Okay. And is his mother has any problem for this? No, because she expected this before itself. Anyway, this job lasted for 2 months. So, she don't have any problem. Anyway, she expected this. Okay? Yes? You understood? Okay. So, this chapter is completed. You are thorough with the chapter. Now, you want to read this chapter 3 times for the next class, and also one assignment is there. You know what was that? You want to write the profile of Ruskin Bond. Okay. So, if you are able to get a picture of Ruskin Bond, then it is very good. Okay. So, try to get a picture of Ruskin Bond and paste it in your notebook. And then write about him, where he born, everything you can write. Okay. So, we can see with that assignment in the next class. Till then, bye.